evening, everyone. Honorable Member of Parliament, Mr. Zac Goldsmith, honorary members of the society, dear present, dear beautiful guests, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Randy, and I'm from a country called Benin. It's in West Africa, and it's known also as one of the most influential and most powerful old kingdoms. And in fact, my ancestor King Bianzin was the one who decided to abolish the slave trade that was happening in the region, and that's when France unleashed the army on us. And the one piece of history which I'm actually working on a movie project for this, is that this ancestor of mine, King Bianzin, had an all-female army called the Amazons, and there were 40,000 of them. And 3 times in a row, they defeated the French army before the French army was able to capture, the palace and subsequently turn my country temporarily into a colony. So I'm here today because Rebecca, my friend, has invited me to become an ambassador. I've known her now for quite some years. I used to live in London myself. I lived 3 years in London. And I still come often for my business. I run a very large investment fund in Africa called Black Line Holdings. We finance infrastructure, energy, mining, telecoms, all the big projects across 35 African countries. And art is very close to my heart because, in my country, we are known for our art. We have a lot of sculptures spread all around the world. And for the past 20 years, my family, together with the government of Benin, have spent millions of pounds to try to recuperate all the stolen sacred art, sculptures, and everything that we had taken by force, stolen from our country during colonial times, and now sitting in museums all around the world. And I'm happy to say that last year we won the case. So we started repatriating many of the art, the sculptures that we have around museums, not because we don't want them to be seen, but things that were taken by force or stolen, should be returned to the country, and the country should decide what to do with it. So I'm very honored today, and I'd like to congratulate Rebecca and her colleagues on the great work that you're doing, mentoring young women, and I always see you, how you give advice to young women, trying to teach them real values that are important in life, because today we need that more than ever. I have a 6-year-old daughter, and I'm trying to teach her already from this age that, for a woman to be empowered, it should be based on her projects that she has in life, and her ambitions, the kind of career she wants to have, not necessarily having hundreds of thousands of followers because she's showing pictures half naked. That's not what makes her respected or empowered. I respect, of course, the work of models and everything, but what I'm saying is that today we have a generation of young millennials who are losing touch with what real values are in life. And Rebecca is helping, with this change, with this transformation. So again, thank you. I'll do my best in Africa to promote the society, the work. I'll do my best also with the fundraising. I'm very good with that for the different initiatives that we're going to have. And I'll promote this initiative in Africa and around the world as much as possible. So thank you all.